happening. No gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up guys, Craft Farms here, and welcome back to another video. So, I have done a lot since the last video, and a lot has happened since the last video. So, I'll talk about what happened. I did talk about this a little bit in another video, but I'm going to talk about it more in this. So, as you can see, no sale barn, no sugar beet piler, none of that. Where'd it go? Well, I had a corruption happen in my files. I don't know how, I don't know where, I don't know why. I just know that it happened. Okay, so all of this field area that I added, the sugar beet piler and the livestock area, it's all gone. So I just had to redo a bunch of stuff, which, no big deal. It actually kind of helped because I did stuff a little bit differently. Now, I have not added the piler and the livestock sale barn back yet, and I'm not going to quite yet either. I am going to finish all these fields first. Now, I also need to add the crop production services and area to buy seeds. I did not add those yet, so it's kind of a blessing in disguise that this happened, because I'm just doing so much stuff differently now. So now about what I've done. I've added these fields over here. This one here, that one, and that one. And then, so it's kind of a little bit different here, as you can tell. This, it kind of is a little bit farther away from the river, and then that section kind of goes in there a little bit. I changed that. I made this go all the way over to the river, and just made that kind of be its own section as well. Put a section line back in here. I did get a different texture in here. I brought this texture in. This is beach sand that I edited. It's kind of made to look like a kind of field trash texture in a way, but anyway, I brought this all the way back here to this field, and so then I also have these three fields added. You can see it's kind of similar to the way that it is, but then again, kind of not. This whole area here is going to be completely different, this whole area here is going to be completely different. So, and then this area is also different, but as I've said many times, I'm just loosely basing it off of here, not, being exact or anything. So, what we're going to do first is we're going to run a section line down here, get that done. Because I know that there's going to be one here. So what I'm planning on doing is I'm just going to put this entire area into a field, and then I'm going to go in and separate it out into anywhere from 4 to 8 fields of different sizes and whatnot. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to get started here. We're going to put this section line in, and I think it's going to go right there. That looks pretty good. So we'll throw this in quick. So we'll just run this all the way down to a little before the river. Just because I don't know how I'm going to set this field up yet, all these fields up yet, so I will have to, if I need to go and remove some of it later, I can sure easily do that. So that's what my logic is. Rather add too much and need to go back and remove it, then add not enough and have to try and get it added in. So yeah, I was just kind of sitting here the other day thinking, and or yesterday, well, sitting here one day thinking about this, and I'm like, you know, I don't have a whole lot of small fields on here. They're mostly, like, ginormous, especially over in this section. As we get over here, there are some smaller fields, like that one there is going to be smaller, that one there is a little smaller, that's a little smaller. That's a little bit smaller-ish. That's a little smaller-ish. So, you know, there are a few smaller fields, and I am going to add a couple of fields back in here as well, as I mentioned before. So, that's also going to be nice. But, you know, just there aren't a whole lot of small fields on here. So I figured I'd make this entire area a field and then just sit and make it into a bunch of fields, some being small, some being medium, some being large. So I haven't decided how many fields I want to separate it out into either, if it's going to be 4 fields, 5 fields, 6, 7, 8, maybe more, maybe less than 4 even. You know, well, it's definitely not going to be less than 4. I can guarantee that right now. And it's probably not really going to be close to 4 either, because, you know, 4 would be still kind of large, so. Okay, so now we got that done. So now we're just going to go back along this and remove the grass that is on it. I'm actually gonna make the brush just a little bit bigger. I did try one time when I tested the mapping game, I did try opening the doors on the Century 21. They did not open, but I have a feeling it's because I don't have the animation door trigger script added into the map yet. The roll-up doors do open. Because those will open on any map I've found. You don't have to have the script added for them. So that's kind of nice, but it does need to get added for other doors. So I did not try the doors at the in the Morton building at Triple R Repair. So I don't know if those work. I would assume not, since the trigger or the script is not added in yet. So I'm just assuming, but I don't know. I didn't try them. I also haven't tried the cell trigger yet. But I'm not too worried about it right now. I'll test that once I get all these fields added. I'm gonna throw the map in game and do some testing, and I'll test out all the triggers and does that look even? No, it does not. How about now? There we go. That looks good. Okay, so now we'll throw this down to 0.5. We'll add the grass in the center of the road. I've had many people ask me why I put the strip of grass down the middle of the road, and that's because this is a section line. Section lines have grass down the middle of them, between where your tires go. So that is the reasoning for that. And usually it's not very straight either. Grass is kind of wavy and whatnot, so I don't usually like worry about it being straight. Sometimes it's straighter than others. Some spots I have it straighter. Others, like here, not so much. But that's how things are. Nothing is exactly the same. That one got a little bit far off of where I wanted it. I can hear a helicopter going by. Alright, we're almost to the end, and then we can start throwing in some field. There's one field that I'm really dreading doing, and that is that one over there. One, it is ginormous, and two, because of all of the waviness in it and whatnot, that was just going to be kind of a nuisance, I think. But we will find out when we get to it. I'm saving that field for last. That's, I know that for sure. But yeah. Okay, so let's get our sizing, our angling here, whatever you want to call it. I think we'll bring it out to right there. We'll run this down to by the river. So yeah, basically what I'm going to do is go in and I will, of course, redo. Go in, add the entire field, or, you know, make this entire section a field, and then brain fart. And then I'll go back in and figure out how I want to size it, and then just add strips of grass in between it, and away we go. Okay, we'll throw this down to 7. We'll go, we need to leave it as square for a second. We'll go to round. Got a little bit off there. Okay, so now I'll go back to square. We'll go back to 20. We'll go to grass, and then we'll make it so that way we can see this section here that we've been adding. So yeah, in this video, this is basically all that we're going to do is add these few fields here. Okay. So now I'll just get close to up here, and then we'll round off this corner up here. Okay, so let's round this down. Did that actually work? Kind of. Almost. Kinda almost. Kinda sorta almost. Worked on a doing it that way. There, that actually turned out pretty good. Back to removing grass we go here for a second. And then that actually turned out pretty nice. Okay. Terrain detail, and away we go. So now we'll just go straight down here, but I will follow the curve of the road. I'm just going to start off by going straight, and then I'll get all the way down to the end, and then I'll add that part in. So I will have that little curve. Oh, you would. You dumb thing. This thing does stuff so backwards. This is just ridiculous. So currently I have the video from earlier today uploading. That's the My Summer Car video for Sunday. And then this is the mapping video for Sunday, being recorded here on Thursday. So, alright, we're nearly to the end here. And we'll put it down to right there. And we gotta add grass all along here. I think I did it on this side already, yeah. Just make sure that I did it all along here. And I did, so that is good to go. Anyhow, let's remove the grass. We can go in and add the grass along the edge of the map after the field is done. It's not too much of a worry right now. Really, it's not that big of a deal if that doesn't get added, but I'd kind of like it to be added. And if I don't get that one to work, I do know that the county line map has the original UM Realty building on it. So I can just take the door off of that one if this one doesn't work, but I don't see why it wouldn't. Once I add animation map trigger, Maybe we'll add that quick in this video too, I don't know. We'll see how much time I've spent once how much time I've been recording. How long I've been recording. Jeez, words are hard. We'll see how long I've been recording when we get all this field stuff done. And then we'll go from there. Okay, so now we'll change this to round, and we're going to run it right about there. Best part about making a map that's only loosely based on an area is doing exactly what I'm doing. I can make these kind of changes. You know, like, because I'm not going exact to this actual area, I can make these changes in these fields, and I can make changes in roads and whatever else that I wanted to, because I'm not going exact of how it is, like I would be on my map, my other map, on my Will Brothers Farms map. See, that one's got to be, you know, as spot on as I can get it, because it is being really, really, really based on a real area. You know, this map is just loosely based. So, okay, so now we're going to remove all of the grass in this area here. So that way we don't have to deal with this area when we're going back and doing the rest of the field. Just because this is a little area that's just more of a pain than anything. Okay, so now we'll head as far over that way as we can get. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. It's gonna make me redo all of that. How dumb. Giants editor. Gotta love it. So we still got a little ways to the river. You can see here we got a lot of terrain change. Okay, so that's probably about as far as we want to go. Then we can use the round brush to get in there a little bit farther, a little bit closer, whatever you want to call it. Alright, let's go along this river. I still really like this dirt texture. My favorite texture of all. Okay, so we are just about connected, and then we can go in and remove all the grass. We can leave that round. Okay. I need to sit and make a checklist of what is all left to do on this map. And there really isn't a whole lot left, like item-wise. I mean, there is a lot of work left to be done because of all of the fence that needs to be added. It's gonna take like forever for all this fence to be added. But it will be worth it in the end. I just gotta keep telling myself that. Be like, okay, this is gonna be worth it. Don't just quit. Okay, fine. Okay, so now let's sit and remove some grass, shall we? Actually, let's make this a little bit smaller here for a moment. So what I'm going to do is kind of cut this into sections. Okay, now we'll make this 50. We'll go terrain detail. I'm going to do this in sections in terms of doing the grass and whatnot removal. So that way it's just a little bit easier going. And now we'll cut out another section here. Normally, I can zoom out far enough. Ooh, I might have just messed up there. Yeah, not too bad, though. We'll just make this a lot smaller, and then we can fix this. There we go. Normally, I can zoom out far enough that I can see the entire field. But with this being as big as it is, that's not quite going to work that way. Just going to have to zoom out in sections. Okay, on to the next one. What? Are you kidding me? Well, we'll have to clear that up, I guess, as well. That, of course, won't be done with this big of a brush. That we'll go back and do with a smaller one. Okay. All right, so now we'll drop this down to 20. We'll go back to grass. And then we'll go down to, let's make it actually 8 or 6, we'll do. And then terrain details. Okay. We'll change it to that. We can close that, and I just want to take a screenshot of this just to send to a couple of guys. Oh man, this headset's starting to get uncomfortable. Been wearing it for way too long. Expand the canvas, and I'll just leave that open. Okay, so now comes the fun part of deciding how I want to split this. So, first split is going to be right here. Shoot. I think actually I can just uncheck that. I can just use my right mouse button. That way if I get like that, I can just go in and fix it quick. I don't have to do a bunch of changes. You know what? Actually, I am gonna make this 8. Let's actually go down here and do this once. This will give me the perfect line. That way I have enough room to put, I can put my gravel road, and then I can still put fence on either side of the road. So, I mean, it's gonna be plenty big, and there'll still be plenty of field. I'm not chopping off too much. Spot there. Yeah, this is still going to be plenty big. I might even split this into 3 down here. I mean, this is huge. Have like 3 smaller fields or more. Maybe what I'll do is I'll split this section into like the smaller fields, and then I'll divide this somewhere and then have like 4 larger fields or medium fields, and then do like 2 or 3 large fields. Holy smokes, this is huge. Not too worried about that one spot. Sweet, we actually don't need to do anything there. I'm not worried about right here because I'm going to make this a rounded off corner. Okay, now we'll hop into grass mode. Okay, so now we need to make this, let's see, 7.5 probably, yeah. Now, I gotta think, I don't know if I want to make this video too terribly long. So I don't know, maybe what I'll do is end it, and then in the next video I'll show you guys this section completed or something. I don't know. Yeah, I think that's what I'll do. We'll finish off this grass first, though. What the world was that? Heard some kind of weird noise outside. Could have been somebody's car door or something too, I guess. I'm probably not going to do all the section lines until all of these are marked out anyways, because then that way I can tell, okay, maybe this one needs to stop here, or okay, this needs to go all the way down to here and whatnot. Then I don't have to redo some stuff. I mean, that one gravel road that we did, that one will be fine. That one's probably all right, running right to where it is. And we can just branch off of it however I need to. So we're almost done here. See, like I was saying, what I'll do is I'll end the video now, and then I will finish all of this, all of these fields here between now and whenever I record Wednesday's video. And then I will come back and I will show you guys all of what I did. Whoa. Okay, so we'll round this off yet, and then that'll be it. Ooh, too far. Perfect. Alright guys, so yeah, that is going to do it for this video. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Be sure to subscribe if you like what you see. Be sure to turn on the post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. Be sure to check out down below in the description for my PC specs, my upload schedule, as well as links to all of my social medias and some other cool YouTube channels that are worth taking a look at. Thanks for watching, you guys, and as always, we'll see you tomorrow.